Hey people, welcome back to another video of Circuit Digest. So in this video, we're going to tell you the difference between passive buzzer and active buzzer. Now the thing is, most of these buzzers look exactly like same. So what we're going to do is we're going to show you how to physically differentiate between an active buzzer and a passive buzzer just by looking at it, and also how to use both of them in a circuitry and check if they're working, and also show you what's inside a passive buzzer and what's inside an active buzzer. So first, let's start with the physical appearance. So as you can see, this here is an active buzzer and this here is a passive buzzer. So the active buzzers normally get shipped with a sticker on top, but for some reason, if this sticker is removed, we can still identify a active buzzer and a passive buzzer by just looking at the backside of it. So active buzzers will always have a plain finish on the backside, and passive buzzers will have some kind of a PCB finish on the backside. So the main difference between an active buzzer and a passive buzzer is that the active buzzer has a crystal inbuilt of it. So if you directly power it with a 9-volt battery, it will make a sound, but the passive buzzer will not do so. So we have an active buzzer here. Let me quickly power it on with this 9-volt battery and this 5-volt voltage regulator. As you can see, as soon as I power it on with the battery, you can see that the buzzer makes a sound. Now, if I replace this active buzzer, which has a plain finish on the bottom, with a passive buzzer, which I have over here, let me quickly replace this. And now if I try the same circuitry again, you will see nothing happens. So for a passive buzzer, you can't just directly power it with a battery and expect it to work. What we have to do is use a Arduino board to generate a PWM signal, or any board to generate a PWM signal, and provide it to the passive buzzer. So to test a passive buzzer, we have a passive buzzer connected to an Arduino Uno here. Let me quickly power it on. So as you can see, as soon as I power it on, the buzzer starts working. So this is how a passive buzzer works. It doesn't have a crystal inside, so you have to provide a PWM signal externally. So this is a passive buzzer. Now let's see what would happen if I use a active buzzer from here, from this circuitry, inside this circuitry, and let's see what happens. So as you can see, it still works, but the quality of the buzzer is not that good. So when you're using functions like tone functions, it is recommended to use a passive buzzer. When you're just going to directly just beep it with a transistor or with a power supply, it is recommended to use an active buzzer. So that's it, guys. This is how you use an active buzzer and a passive buzzer. Just to make it a bit more interesting, we popped open a passive buzzer and an active buzzer. So this is the vibrating drum. Let me just remove it. So if you look inside, I wouldn't say there is much of a difference. So you can see that in the passive buzzer, we don't find this blue color layer, but in the active buzzer, we can find this blue color layer. So that's it, guys. This is how you differentiate between an active buzzer and a passive buzzer. This is how you use them in a circuitry. For more details, you can check out the link in the description. Thanks for watching. If you learned something, do consider subscribing to this channel. Thank you. Bye-bye.